Tip number one, your New Year's resolution should have started a few weeks ago, if not a few months ago, but there's nothing quite like the present, so here we go. Happy New Year, everybody. Thankfully, we can put 2020 in the rearview mirror, and hopefully 2021 is going to be much, much better. And I'm going over my five tips today to follow your fitness resolutions that a lot of you are going to be setting. I already went over the first one, and if you stick to the very end, I actually have a bonus tip for you as well. So getting into tip number two, it is about setting your goals. Now, you should be setting a goal because that's very important, but what you should be concentrating on is the expectations of those goals. Don't set a goal that's unrealistic or something that's way beyond what you actually are going to be able to accomplish. So what I'm talking about here, let's say you're trying to increase your bench press. Don't set your goal to a 100-pound increase by the end of the year. Unless you're an absolute beginner, that's not gonna happen. If you're an advanced lifter, that's impossible. Set it to something a lot more realistic, maybe 15 or 20 pounds total by the end of the year. That's way more realistic and something you can actually stick with and actually accomplish. If your goal is to lose weight, again, don't make it something absolutely ridiculous. Pick an ideal body weight that you'd like to reach, one that you know you can reach in a healthy way, and stick to that. Again, for those who may not know, the safest and healthiest way to lose weight is to lose 1 to 2 pounds per week at most. This is gonna help you actually stick with your diet and something that's gonna be much more not only healthy but also sustainable. So that way when you reach your target weight, you're already used to the restriction in calories and you're much less likely to actually resort back to your old habits. So again, make your goals realistic, something you can actually stick with and you believe you can actually accomplish. Now this goes into tip number three, which is being specific with your goals. Now, like I mentioned, it's important to be realistic, but you also need to be specific. It's not necessarily enough to just say, I wanna lose weight, or to say that I wanna increase strength in my bench press. Be specific with it. If you wanna increase your bench press by 15 to 20 pounds, say that. If you wanna lose 20, 30 pounds body weight, say that, okay? Be as specific as possible so you're able to actually have an end goal in mind. And then tip number four, to keep track of all this, you should write it all down in a notebook, especially your workouts. So again, if you're trying to increase your bench press, keep track of each of your workouts so you can keep track of your progress. See where you are. If you're trying to lose weight, keep track of how much progress you're making in that. Keep track of what you're eating, your diet. All this sort of stuff, okay? If you don't write anything down, you're not gonna necessarily know where you are, how much progress you're actually making. And then the fifth tip here, guys, is about accountability. Tell your friends, your family, everybody about it. Have them make you be accountable for all this. Make it so that you promise them or give them your word that you're actually gonna follow these resolutions, that you're actually try your best and actually attempt to reach your goals. So that way when they keep track of your progress too, or check up on you, you can actually tell them and have it so you're actually accountable for it. And it ties into tip number four here. If you write everything down, you're keeping yourself a bit accountable that way as well. Okay, at the end of the day, guys, you can tell yourself you're gonna follow these goals, but you need to actually be accountable for it. And one of the best ways is to tell other people that you're doing it, your friends, your family, so that they can help you keep accountable as well. And as I mentioned, I had a bonus tip here for you guys, which is just the fact that you're gonna have to accept that reaching goals and sticking with your resolutions is very difficult and it's gonna suck. Especially if you're trying to lose weight or something like that, you don't wanna make it a huge change. You wanna make it something that you can follow slowly and progress into, okay? You don't wanna bite off more than you can chew. But at the end of the day, changing what you've been doing, guys, it's very hard. Changing your diet is really hard. It sucks, like I said, okay? Trying to increase strength on your bench press takes a lot of training sessions to do. Again, it's gonna be a lot of suffering, a lot of stuff that's you're not gonna wanna necessarily go through. But if it's truly what you wanna do, and you truly actually wanna reach that goal, then you're gonna have to do it. There's no other way to do it. There's no other way of putting it, guys. Okay, the hardest part is starting. This isn't part of what I'm talking about in this video. If you just start, you just step into your car, you just get to that gym, you will find it much easier. The hardest part isn't necessarily doing it, it's actually starting it and actually beginning all this stuff. Getting into the gym, starting to count calories, buying better foods. All that stuff is much easier once you actually start. So start. All right, guys, so those are my five tips and a bonus tip for my New Year's resolutions for your fitness goals. Hopefully you found this helpful, and I really hope that you do reach your goals for this year. And I will be back to a new review next week, and I will see you guys then.